Nikola Tesla moved to America, where at the time, he was well recognized as a genius inventor and for his impressive engineering abilities. The height of his career allowed him to express his ideas and was the triumph he had waited for. His brilliance led to the discovery of inventions that used electricity to improve the way of life across the globe. During his time in America, from the late 1800s to early 1900s, he went up against an American giant, Thomas Edison, where they and their supporting companies would battle between AC and DC. This started a conflict between them, and they both tried to produce their best work, in order to prove that one was better than the other. Although he was one of the best inventors, his poor economic and social skills led to the tragedy of his career. Living in expensive hotels and never investing, he died penniless and alone, but his legacy still lives on in our society.
Tesla was a natural-born genius as a child, even being accused of cheating by teachers because of how well he did. His mother, Duka Tesla, had built machines where it helped in daily tasks at home and on the farm, sparking interest in Tesla to be an engineer. He saw a steel engraving of Niagara Falls, which inspired his early interest in engineering and power.
In his imagination, there appeared a huge water wheel being turned by the powerful cataract. As a child, he was set back by his father's standards, Milutin Tesla, who was a loving but stern father to Tesla, being a role model to him. A very erudite man, a venerable natural philosopher, poet, and writer.
His father was much more religious than he was, and often pushed his son to follow his example as a priest, and was also a poet that often inspired Tesla to be who he was.
Much admired sentences full of wit and satire.
Pressuring him to be a priest up until the age of 17, where he contracted cholera. Scared to lose his other son, his father promised to send him off to a renowned school in order for him to study to be an engineer.
Perhaps I may get well if you let me study engineering. I knew he meant it. A heavy weight lifted from my mind.
After he was cured and was healthy again, he later attended the Joannam Polytechnic School in Graz, Austria, and excelled in his studies where his instructor demonstrated the power of electricity. After many hardships that led to the revocation of his scholarship, several years later, with the help of his mother and her uncles, he attended another college, Carl Ferdinand University. While looking through newspapers, he found an article about Thomas Edison building a telephone exchange in Budapest. He moved there and found employment and inspiration.
Every day, I imagined arrangements of this plan without result, but feeling I was nearing a solution.
In late 1882, Tivadar Puskas invited Tesla to Paris. And while he was there, he showed Thomas Edison's staff about his vision of an early idea of an AC motor that he dreamed of. His executives saw the talent he had and sent him to Strasbourg, where he repaired an old lighting system that short-circuited.
Seeing his potential, Charles Batchelor, Edison's advisor, invited Tesla to travel to New York to actually meet Edison. Charles Batchelor said to Edison in a letter, "I know two great men, and you are one of them. The other is this young man."
He arrived with very little and only brought 4 cents.
Remnants of my belongings, some poems and articles I had written, and a package of calculations relating to the solutions of an unsolvable integral into my flying machine, he claimed.
On the second day in the United States, he met Thomas Edison, and was immediately set to work on a broken lighting system upon a ship called the SS Oregon, and was hired by Edison to work for him. They both possessed traits such as thriving on work and needing little sleep to function. While although they worked well together at times, occasionally they clashed about the idea of AC, and Tesla was often ignored when he suggested the idea.
Very bluntly, that he was not interested in alternating current. There was no future to it, and anyone who dabbled in the field was wasting his time. And besides, it was a deadly current, whereas direct current was safe. When Edison made a joke about an offer of $50,000 if Tesla succeeded in achieving an efficient dynamo, taking it seriously, Tesla did so, and when he was not paid, he left the company.
After leaving the company, he worked as a ditch digger that gave him little to no money at all. There was then word going out about a genius inventor working on the streets. After many investors tried to get him to work for them, they all did not want to go through with the idea of pursuing AC current. And one time he was even left behind and kicked from the company.
He wound up with a handsomely engraved stock certificate, but had little redeemable value.
Although he went through hard times, one company called Westinghouse wanted to invest in him and followed all of his ideas perfectly, and even supported the idea of AC current. With this company, though, their main rival was Thomas Edison, who still believed in DC power and often doubted AC and its potential.
Edison moved on to spread rumors and lies in order to ruin the reputation of AC current and its success. But Nikola Tesla pushed forward and had projects that helped push the idea of AC current. These projects included a hydroelectric plant at Niagara Falls. He powered the Chicago World Fair, showing the world the power of AC current. He was recognized for his achievements as a genius around the world. Tesla instinctively gravitated to the glass-enclosed palm room to see and be seen by the money men.
Controversy arose when Nikola Tesla accused Marconi of stealing his ideas of the radio, and even sued him, but lost the case soon after. He slowly lost money and the fame he once gathered. With the death of George Westinghouse, he lost not only the only investor that truly understood his ideas, but also someone who he trusted. His social fears and habits caused him to stray from other people and affected his career. As Nikola Tesla grew older, he started to hide from the public eye, where he relied on pigeons to talk to instead of human contact. Although he still had the brilliant ideas that could be put to use, it wasn't practical in world use.
He would have to terminate Tesla's contract, which called for royalty. For the next few years, he still believed he was the best electrical inventor, but he did nothing. For a little cash, he also took on odd jobs.
He lost all the money he had and lived a poor, lonely life in a hotel room where he spent most of his time in.
Although Tesla had little money at this point, at least he had no debts.
This hotel room, however, was in the Hotel New Yorker, where it later drained his money into debt, where he was unable to pay it off, and never invested in a long-term estate.
In order to pay off most of his debt, he pretended to build a death beam and sold it to a hotel for $10,000.
The income he had was barely enough to cover all of his expenses, and people lost faith in him. On the day of January 7th, 1943, at the age of 86, Nikola Tesla died in his hotel room, without any money or friends nearby. His death caused a nationwide shock, and companies such as Westinghouse and J.G. White Engineering Company attended the ceremony.
More than 2,000 persons attended the service. The city was represented by Newbold Morris, president of the city council. Following his death, issues arose when some of his research and patent papers went missing, because people tried to find the death beam he had supposedly built.
The supposed death beam, hidden at the hotel, was carefully approached, but when it was opened, it only revealed a box full of mechanical parts.
The technology involved has proved to be complex and difficult, raising questions of its feasibility. A couple centuries later, he is now recognized as one of the most brilliant inventors known to man, and inspired many others.
Some popular entrepreneurs, like Elon Musk, who even called his car manufacturer Tesla, was inspired by his inventions and motor. Some of today's technology use the same type of AC current that he promoted. These included toasters and electric cars that reuse on a daily basis.
Even through the hardships he endured, he was still able to come up with brilliant ideas that allowed him to succeed in certain aspects of life. Working without any breaks, Nikola Tesla achieved some of the most difficult accomplishments, and this included finding a solution to giving safe electricity nationwide. Without any goal in mind, he explored all types of electricity and invented different inventions that further progressed his knowledge. He was completely invested in electricity and its wonders, and dedicated his life to it. He did not focus on his investments and future, which led to his downfall. Even without trying to promote himself, Nikola Tesla still had people who believed in him and his projects and inventions. Though many may have forgotten his name, his brilliance still exists today through his legacy of inventions that changed the way we live.